You know, this is one of my favorite books. It's called Armor Bearers. And when I wrote this book many years ago, this is on its fourth publication. It's actually written in several languages. It's written in Indonesian, it's written in Spanish, French, and other languages as well. But one of the things about this book that makes it so unique is that I wrote it to help people understand what an armor bearer is and is not. So I say very clearly that an armor bearer is not an entourage to make a preacher look famous or look like security guards around them. This is not, you know, these preachers that have to have an entourage of people around them to make them look like the most important man in the room. That's not what I see as an armor bearer. I see an armor bearer as someone who comes along, someone spiritually prays for them, upholds them, encourages them. So I wrote this book to try to save some ministries, because there's a lot of ministers, more than we should even ever have to think about, that are leaving the ministry discouraged, burnt out, and just beat up. So this first chapter of this book is called The Choir of Cave Singers. And I talk about David's plight from Saul and how discouraged he was in the cave. And he wrote some cave songs while he was in the cave. And so this whole chapter called The Choir of Cave Singers is probably the chapter that grips the heart of these hurting pastors more than anybody. I have stacks and stacks of letters and emails that have come to me from people that said, when I read the first chapter, I just broke down and cried. And I realized that the Lord had written this for me. So I just want to read a little bit of this one chapter just as a part of this book. So it's called The Choir of Cave Singers. It's in chapter one. There's a section on hiding places and singing cave songs and all the things that David went through, and I even list some of his cave songs. But I just want to read the last part. This is what the last section of this book reads like. It's called The Choir of Cave Singers. Many people who are reading this book belong to the Choir of Cave Singers. Your paths have not been easy, but in the midst of despair, remember that God loves cave songs, so don't forget to sing. There's no way to hear this choir on this side of heaven, for the members are scattered throughout the earth. However, God hears their song. Each voice is raised toward heaven and joins a massive chorus that reaches the ears of the Almighty. Now, who is in this choir, you may ask? Those names will not be mentioned here, but here is a description of their song. God hears the cries of those who have preached to cold and empty pews, who have never gotten a single amen, who have propped themselves up to preach, those who beat out the paths so others could find the way, those who logged the midnight hours. And God shows mercy to those who have had to hold their own tears so that someone else could cry. Those who have given more care than they have ever received. Those who have filled others' hands while walking empty-handed. Those who have watched others take credit for their hard work and never said a word. Those who have bled so others could belong. God gives blessings to those who have never owned a house, who have never seen the ocean, who were limited by the traditions of men in their ministry, who had to dream in silence, those whose courage outmatched their fears. And God answers the prayers of those who have lifted up weary hands, who have trimmed their own wicks to keep their own flame burning, those who have turned paths into trials and trials into those who have turned paths into trails and trails into roads, those who had to cross the finish line limping, and those who showed up, never gave up, and one day are going up because they said yes to God. There's a lot more in this chapter, but that's the section that dedicates this book to every person who needs an armor bearer. May the Lord bless you today. And if you're going to cross the finish line limping, keep singing until you get there.